Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. In the last video, we talked about component events. And in this video, we are still going to talk about component events. Because there's one thing that I didn't mention about in the last video, which is I feel it's important and you should know about component events, which is about event bubbling. So event bubbling, it's not a concept in it's a concept in elements events. So if you have elements like this over here, as you can see, when I click on any of the buttons, element button 1 or 2, and the events will bubble up to the parent. So if I even if I click on the buttons and I don't, the events will be bubble up, meaning any of the parents that listens to the event should be able to listen it, should be able to trigger the events handler even if it's on a parent level, right? So this button, when I click, if it has an event listeners, it will be handled, and then it will bubble up. If it's not propagation, then it will propagate up, right? It will go to the parent, which is this div, and then go to this parent. And then in this parent, you have the event listeners registered. You are listening to on click. So the on element button click event listener will be triggered. And therefore, you can console out the value. Of course, it's still the event's target, the elements that is this, the click is on, is this two buttons. So if I check the dataset.value, which is the data value attribute over here, I can get button 1 or 2, right? So if I click on the element button 1 or button 2, you can see that this is being triggered and you can get button 1 or button 2. So this is events bubbling in DOM elements. But what about components? If I have in the app, I have this parent component listening to this component button click, right? So if I look into parent, I have another component called child. If I look in the child, I have another component called grandchild. And in the grandchild, I have another component, which is, okay, no, it does not have. So it has two buttons, same two buttons. I have button one and button two. Wait, hold on. Button two does not have one click. Let me add it in. So button one and button two have two on click event listeners. And over here, I am dispatching component events. I use create event dispatcher to create a dispatch, and I dispatch component button click event, and I pass in the events. I pass in data like button one and button two, so that the component when I listens to it, I can get event.detail and will access the button one or button two. So will this event, when I click, will it bubble up to the parent, which is this child component, to its parent, which is this parent component, and then to its parent again, which is this app.component, and receives it from here, and the name is the same, and then you get handle over this on component button click callback function, handler functions. Does it, will it work? Well, let's see. Let's click. Well, it does not work. Okay. That's why we make this video, because I'm going to tell you how you can make it work. So first and foremost, I have to tell you, unfortunately, component events does not bubble, meaning it does not go one lap, it does not go through all its parents and then bubble up all the way to this app.svelte, right? It does not bubble all the way to this parent component over here. So what I can do instead is a workaround. Sadly, it's a workaround. So I have to come over here on child. I'm dispatching an event from this grandchild, right? So I can definitely listen to this event called a component button click. I can listen to this, so I can handle it over here. I come over here and create this event. So if I come over here and I say in child.svelte and take a look at event.detail. Hopefully this works. If I click yes, you can still see button one, button two. Right, so if I want to bubble up to the parent, like bubble, it does not bubble, right? So if I want my parent, which is in this parent.svelte, to able to listen to this event, I'll have to dispatch this event myself. So I have to come over here, import create event dispatcher. Whoops. And I am going to create this dispatch function. Whoops. And then I'm going to dispatch this event. Okay, so I'm going to dispatch. I'm going to use the same name so that the parent can listen to the same name as well. And I can come over here and pass in the same data, which is the event.detail. Right, so I'm going to come over here, paste it in comment. Okay, I can still leave it in. So with this in place, I can come over here to my parents and listen to it. I can listen to this component button, click. Event console in parent.svelte and events.detail. Right, let's see. So I click, yes, my child receives it, and then I dispatch the same, it's not the same event per se, but I dispatch a new event with the same event name and the same data so that in the parent I can register, I can listen to that event and can log out the data as well, so I get the same data. So in order for my app.svelte over here to listen to it, I need to do the same dance again. I need to come over here, copy this, paste this in. I have dispatch, come over here, dispatch the same event. So I'm going to dispatch the same event name, which is component button click, so that in app.svelte I can listen to it. All right, so the moment of truth, let's click the button. And now you see on component button click logs out the data, right? Finally, after passing one by one, it's like running a relay marathon where you relay this, you relay the events from the grandchild to the child to the parent and then all the way to the app.svelte. So if you look up this on the Svelte website or documentation, it's called event forwarding. You have forward the event from one place to another, to the parents, all the way to its parents, to its parents, and therefore you achieve this event bubbling effect that you would get it normally in DOM elements. Of course, this is a lot of keystrokes to type, so Svelte comes up with a shorthand, right? Everything that is annoying, a lot of keystrokes, we have shorthands for it. So if you are listening to this event and you're going to dispatch the same event, right, you're dispatching the same event, you can come over here and just do this instead. So you can remove all this and there you go. So you click, still works, right? You still dispatch all the way. So you listen to the events and dispatch to the parents and do like forward it, right? So it's the same thing that we've written so far, except that so let me keep this. I comment it out so that you can compare. So previously is you have to register your own event listeners and you do a dispatch your own. Now you forward it by just doing this. So I click again. Everything works. You forward all the way to its parent. So there you have it, event forwarding shorthand. And this shorthand actually does not just apply to components. I have to show you that this actually applies to elements as well. So if I come over here and I do this, then this is actually the same shorthand of adding on shorthand of, so previously we were doing, okay, let me copy this and so that we can comment it out. All right, so previously we were adding event listeners to on click one and then dispatch this event. So if you do this, then this is the same as dispatching the event of the same name, right, of this name. So I'm gonna, this is the same as doing this on click on the button. So you can listen to, so we, if we want to forward all the way to the top, we do this, copy this, forward it up, and then come over here at Svelte and let's listen to this. So I'm gonna, whoops, what's going on? So I have my inline event handlers. Okay, it's a bit hard to read, so I'm going to tap in. So I have my inline event handlers, and I'm going to come over here and console log on click in @.svelte, and I have, yeah, and there you go. And let's click on the click me two, right, on button, on component button click, and click me one, which is on click in app.svelte. So we, you can use this shorthand on elements as well, on element, on element events as well, DOM events as well. It will be the same as how writing this, right? So this code over here, it's not evaluated. We are not passing on click one to anywhere, right? So this is just to demonstrate that if you write this instead and dispatch click, then it will be exactly the same as using on colon click shorthand. So when would you use this on DOM elements? Well, usually if you create a component that is kind of like a button, and you button with a different styles, or you come up with an input, but input with a different styles or different behaviors, more logics, and you want to bubble up the DOM events to the parent as well, so that if I come over here, have a custom button, and I have my button over here, as I say, a custom button, and I want to forward this DOM event, on click DOM event, to the parent as well, so that I can import custom event, custom button, and listen to click event, then I can do this, right? This will save me time of having to register event listeners and then manually create event dispatcher and dispatch the same, create an event of the same name. So there you have it, component events forwarding. So component event part two, event forwarding. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, like to ask, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.